to learn the good, the bad, and the reality of the nomadic lifestyle, click the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. Click the bell notification. So as I try to do about once a month, and it's been about a month this time, I try to answer some common questions and comments that are on the YouTube channel and the Facebook page, although I haven't been on Facebook very often. So I have a list of questions and different things I'll go through. And then, of course, sometimes I just throw in some miscellaneous information in here that's good to know, but it's just not long enough to make a video. One of the comments that I frequently get is, there's just no way, I don't care how pretty it is here at the Grand Canyon, there is just no way I would go to the desert. Well, Arizona is just considered a desert area, but it's not. There is just as much forest as there is desert. And now, as far as it being hot, everybody wants to know how hot it is here in the desert. It's not. I'm up here at 8,900 feet, and most every day has been in the 70s. The other thing is there's no rain in the desert. Well, just yesterday I did a live feed where I showed you a monsoon coming our way. Yeah, there's a lot of rain in the desert. Now, being up this high, I'm not hit by the monsoons quite as often. But we are getting now to, I guess, the season where the rain is hitting us every evening, at least for, you know, an hour or so. I've been able to collect several buckets of water now. Speaking of water, I'm actually surprised how few people know how to collect water. I've gotten a lot of questions. I just assumed when I made my videos that everybody would know how to collect water. My camper, no matter what you do, you're never completely level with a truck camper. I mean, you can do things, and you know, we have stabilizers, and I jack one side up higher than the other. But what I try to always do is, if I'm going to be off level, which I'm always off level, I always try to make sure that my feet are always lower than my head when I lay down. So that typically means that the driver's side of the truck is always lower. The other thing I try to do is I try to always get the nose, I don't know why, this is not that important, more for just collecting rain. I always try to get the nose lower than the back end. But when you pour water on top of the roof, it all runs to the driver's side corner of the camper. Take buckets right underneath that corner, all the water that is collected on the roof funnels right down to that corner, down the side of the wall of the camper, right into the bucket. And within a couple minutes on a good downpour, you know, a half hour or so, I got 5 gallons of water. Whereas if I just stuck the bucket out in the field, you'd only get, you know, however much it rained. Let's say it rained an inch. So you have a 5 gallon bucket with an inch of water in it. You wouldn't get very much. Mice. The entire time that we've been doing the nomadic lifestyle, we've only had 3 mice, if you want to count one of them. When we had the pop-up camper, we had a mouse that was hiding underneath the bumper of the pickup truck. So we weren't even living in the truck yet. And the only reason I knew we had a mouse there is I saw him on the bumper one day. I put a mouse trap there on the bumper, and sure enough, he came up there and got in the trap. Then we were in Florida for about 2 months during hunt season. And so the pop-up camper was just parked in one spot for 2 months. During that time, we had 2 mice. Not a huge problem. Ever since we've owned the truck camper, we've never had a mouse. Well, since we've been here though, we've had a mouse issue quite significantly. Out of a month now, we've caught 9 mice in 2 different locations here in Arizona. The other thing is I've never had a rodent problem under the hood of the truck. And just the other day, I showed you a video where they ate the wires underneath the truck. And I put cayenne pepper down on the engine compartment. I've got mouse traps everywhere. I got a battery-operated LED light that I put underneath the engine, in the engine compartment. I recharge those batteries every day. It's a AA battery, you can buy them at Walmart. When you come to Arizona, make sure you got mouse traps everywhere. I think that's the best solution. Just put them everywhere, underneath the hood, underneath the truck, in your camper, everywhere. Generator, somebody asked me a long time ago to let you know how the generator does up in these higher elevations. Jerry is the one that asked. Unfortunately, when he asked that question, I still have my old generator. And you know, it was a year old. He wanted to know how it was doing. Well, I messed it up a while back and I left gas in it for a month and the gas went bad. So I'm not able to test that generator, but I did buy another Champion generator. I really like this generator a lot, even more than the old one. Uses less gas, feel like it's quieter. There's an aspect of it that I have a problem with is if you fill it with oil to the recommended level, it smokes real bad. And so I had to Google and I found out that the manufacturer of this engine put the wrong specifications of the amount of oil that you're supposed to have in it. Since it had an oil low shutoff on it, I just drained the, I just kept emptying oil out until I got to the low oil engine shutoff. And then I just put a little bit more in there and it runs great. But up here in these elevations, haven't had a lick of issues with it. Somebody asked me about privacy and if, we're left alone up here. Well, here in Arizona, there's not a lot of people that come up here. Maybe the entire time we've been at this campground, we've seen 5 different people. 2 people camped, they stay a couple days and leave. Most everybody just come up here to check out the view and then they leave. They might do some hiking. In comparison to Florida, where Florida, every campground is just packed full. This has been relatively relaxing. But that is because it's so far away from anything. We're 120 miles from anything. But the privacy issue is still an issue. Even the few people that come up here believe it's their right to be in your business. Twice now we've had a privacy issue. Now, here's the thing. Extroverts are going to believe that what I'm saying is because there's something wrong with me. But introverts are going to know exactly what I'm talking about. And this is where the problem comes into play. There's been a lot of studies that suggest that introverts force themselves to interact with society even though they don't want to. But extroverts will try to push their standards of social acceptance onto introverts. And they don't even realize that it's not anything wrong with it. But the problem is anytime I make a video about introverts and extroverts, all the extroverts will come out and say, "Rob, you need to get out and socialize so your condition doesn't get worse." Well, being an introvert isn't a condition. There's nothing wrong with me. It's not a condition. It's just personal way of functioning. So the extroverts, be aware that not everybody wants to socialize. First one wasn't so bad. We were sitting out in lawn chairs. This lady who was doing some rock collection, there's some unique rocks here that she really liked. She sat down on the ground and was talking to Carolyn about these rocks. We were having a conversation, Carolyn and I, and we're quite comfortable in our skin. We don't need to socialize. So it's uncomfortable to us when somebody just walks up to us and says, "Hi, how you doing?" Now the second one was a little bit more concerning. He was camping here actually for a couple days. He had an ATV with him and he comes up with his ATV and he shuts it off. Now our back door is open, but we have this screen netting on our back door. We leave it open for ventilation, but we were inside the camper. And he shuts off his ATV, walks up to the tailgate. "Hey, how you guys doing?" And I said, "Do we know you?" "No, I just wanted to come over and see if you wanted to come over and talk." And I said, "No." "Oh, well, maybe a beer?" I said, "We don't drink." I feel like he was very rude, but to him, he probably feels like we were very rude, that we didn't jump out and immediately said, "Hey, you know, so there's something wrong with us." I recognize that he's an extrovert, but I don't think he recognizes that we're introverts. And there are a lot of commenters who will say, "Oh yeah, I want to come out here to socialize with people." Well, for folks who believe that, you need to understand, not everybody wants to socialize. I actually knew somebody like this. He believed that if you come out to public ground, whether you're inside your camper, inside your tent, doesn't matter. If you're coming out here, you're coming out here because you believe the same way he does. You're coming out here because you're going to go fishing and drinking and having a good time, partying it up at night. And we're all coming out here because we're all like-minded people. When I tried to explain to him that I'm coming out here to be isolated, to be alone, to get away from people, "Well, that just doesn't make any sense. What's the point of doing that? You can do that in your own house." Be aware, there are 2 types of different people. There's the introverts and there's the extroverts. And the introverts need to understand that the extroverts aren't always aware of the introvert people. And the extroverts need to be aware that introverts aren't really that interested in socializing. They come out here to be alone. But the other thing is you got to be aware of is if you're going to decide to walk up on some guy's camper, right up to his tailgate, you might want to recognize that could be a safety issue for you. You know, I get way too many comments from people saying, oh, I just use my firearm. Please be aware that everybody is coming out for their own reasons. Thanks for watching. Click like if you like video, and happy travels.